Web of Deceit, it is absolutely deadly, written by a truth soldier. Many a good person has been unknowingly caught in the web of deceit. Many a good person has at least once in their lives come to the realization that something is very, very wrong with society. Many good people have tried to wiggle their way through the evil web of deceit, only to be consumed by the evil spider. The evil web of deceit is woven into the very fabric of society by the insane. Please understand that to be insane one has to never seek or speak the truth, for truth is absolute and insanity is absolutely the opposite of truth. So the lying evil web weaver has to keep strengthening and building the web so that it will be able to control and eventually consume its intended prey. Like the spider or weaver of a web of deceit has to always cover lies, deceptions with more deceptions. Eventually the web of deceit becomes so solid that good people stop wiggling and eventually lose their freedom in their very lives. Like in nature, the only creatures that can survive and avoid the web are those that observe that the web exists and watch what the web does to the unsuspecting creatures that have been caught in it. So a smart creature will do everything it can to watch for and avoid the web. Unfortunately, the domesticated and civilized human creature no longer pays attention to its survival instincts. The human creature does not know how to stay free of the web of deceit. For the human creature does not even want to see and watch for the web of deceit. So that, now the human creature is not even aware that this huge web of deceit has been erected and now obstructs any passage through life that you may choose. So very intelligent human intellectuals have come to realize that yes, indeed this web of deceit does exist. These truth soldiers, activists, freedom fighters, etc., etc., realize that something needs to be done to deconstruct this evil web of deceit. Some call this evil web the New World Order that was spun as a result of the creation of the first corporation. Please read my article with the same name. The good people try to alert others of this evil web of deceit and inform the good people as to how this web has been so strongly constructed. But the intellectual soon realizes that the human society has been so well deceived that society absolutely refuses to believe that this evil web of deceit even exists. The intellectual has the tools and wisdom to see and fully understand the makings of this web of deceit that threatens all of humanity. But I believe that most intellectuals do not possess the understanding of the reality that this web of deceit is bigger than any individual or organization. That this web has provided the nourishment to feed many offsprings and that now there is a most unnatural spiders existing all over this planet, weaving more and more webs of deceit. There are now so many webs, corporations of deceit in our now unnatural environment that the human creatures now accepts it as natural and a normal course of human evolution. The human creature refuses to see or understand that something evil and horrible has been woven into the very fabric of life. Only the intellectual can understand that this is very real. You see that to be an intellectual, one has to always seek and speak the truth. If one only seeks and speaks the truth, then that individual will become an enlightened and very intelligent intellectual. For only idiots are created by the avoidance of truth. Unfortunately, there is a very unnatural human being that has grown very big and powerful through the ability to create its own food by the creation of money out of thin air. This artificial human is very insane indeed from the power that money has given it. I call this artificial individual a corporate criminal. I will now explain to you the strategy and way to deconstruct and destroy this evil web of deceit. As all evil, evil can only be destroyed by exposing it to the light of truth. All good humans so far have not figured out or understood the formula to do this. Have you ever observed a huge spider's web with the spider always sitting in the center? Imagine if you were an innocent little butterfly and you happened to come along in your free flight of life and flew into this cleverly hidden and well-positioned web of deceit. What would happen? Like all human creatures caught in the corporate financial web of deceit, you would try to scream for help. But no other creature would dare try to approach near the web of deceit you now find yourself in. The more you wiggled, the tighter the web would entrap you until you tired and died. At which point the spider would consume you and grow stronger as a result. The intellectual human has to understand how to avoid this and how to destroy the web of deceit. An intelligent person will one day come to realize that all knowledge leads to the determination that all truth is very, very simple and only lies and deceptions are complicated. So for one to deal with a web of deceit, one has to always stay on the outside of the web and look for the simplest and undeniable truths to reveal the true nature of the web of deceit. If you were to approach a spider's web with a stick of truth and were to just touch that spider's web with that stick, the spider would immediately sense that you are indeed not just a pretty and delicate little butterfly caught in its web. The spider would immediately sense the strength and weight of your little stick of truth, and the spider would run as fast as it can to get off the web. For you see, if you cause the web to collapse while the spider is still in the center of its web of deceit, that the web that the spider has so cleverly constructed would collapse around the spider. The spider would therefore die of its own making. So now the lesson to be understood here is to never enter into the web of deceit, but instead stay on the outside of it. Whereas you will be called the village idiot if you try to speak the truth to the other human creatures around you. But you being a natural and good intellectual human who wants to do something about this clear and present danger to all the pretty butterflies around you, you do not want to watch as the butterflies are killed and consumed. So you then became what some call a truth soldier or activist. The clever weavers of the web of deceit are not too concerned about you. As their web of deceit is so strong and has worked so well and for so long, so you, the good human creature with a conscience, feels lost and helpless. You cannot get the blissfully happy little butterflies to even listen to your warnings. So one day you go back and watch the spider's web at work, pondering what to do to stop this web of deceit. Until one day you realize the web of deceit is held up by only a few but very strong strings that have been attached to the very fabric of what society accepts as the foundation truth of existence. That being society's perceptions of undeniable basic truths. So you see, the web of deceit always starts off from a very solid foundation of truth. The weavers of deceit are very clever indeed. For they will use the foundations of truth to build their web of deceit from. So what do you, the village idiot, do? You look at the very foundation strings of that web of deceit and you find the most undeniable simple sticks of truth to sever those foundation strings that are attached solidly to society. So you stay on the outside of the web and you start hitting the strings that holds the web firmly attached to the very solid fabric of society. If you're successful, you will end up with the fabric blanket of truth that society has been using for so long to keep comfortable. That fabric will now be very dirty and full of old spider's webs. So then society will realize it's time to clean the blanket and the rest of civilization's home of these pesky and dirty spiders once and for all. So I now call on all truth soldiers to start walking with your sticks of truth and start severing all those webs of deceit everywhere you find them. Eventually society will be tired of living in a dirty place and everyone will walk around with their little sticks of truth. This is why a long time ago the British had tally sticks for their currency. It was to prevent the very situation we now dreadfully find ourselves in. These webs of deceit have been able to be created because the spiders have their luxurious home layers to live in and create their offsprings. You will find these big nursing spiders in very dark places where the light of truth does not enter. These places are known as the secret societies and their dens, such as Skull and Bones, the Illuminati, the Freemasons, the Knights of Columbus. It is time for society to clean house and criminalize all secret societies, and their conspiratorial members should be imprisoned. The mother den of all secret societies is the privately and secretly owned Federal Reserve Corporation, the very first ever created corruption. When the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the Enlightenment. Please watch The Money Masters. You can search for it online to watch the whole movie, A Truth Soldier. Copyright notice. You are free to republish Truth Soldier and or Daniel J. Towsey articles in whole form only. You may take quotes from it as long as you provide a link back to the original article and you give attribution to the writer. Being a truth soldier, you are also free to print or email it in whole, only exception being corporations not allowed must read The Origin and Evolution of Freemasonry Connected with the Origin and Evolution of the Human Race, free ebook. In order to gain a true conception of the origin and evolution of Freemasonry, its signs, symbols, and all its rituals and ceremonies, one must have also a knowledge of the origin and evolution of the human race, with all the totemic mysteries performed in sign language by primitive man. They are linked together pari passu, and the answer as to the origin of all our brotherhood can be found only by unraveling the mystery and causes as to why we find different types of the human race, their different beliefs being in many cases analogous, and all using the same signs and symbols, although under different terminology, and scattered over the face of earth and water throughout this world. Includes many illustrations. Pages 254 published, 1920 language, English comments by readers, comment by Prophet, nice analogy. Dan Gallagher, real Lothlorien, says Daniel, I have studied psychology. By definition, insanity is not the opposite of truth. Actually, there are not even on the same sphere of definitions. As I stated on one of your other threads, there is the truth we believe, and there is the truth the universe knows. Any police officer can tell you that if there are 50 witnesses to an event, each of the 50 witnesses can be telling what they believe to be the truth, but all give different statements. That does not mean any of the witnesses are insane, nor are they lying. They are just telling what they believe to be the truth. An example of this is the story of the blind man and the elephant. Daniel J. Towsey says, okay. First, if truth exists, which it does, then what is the opposite? You have not indicated that. Insanity is an absolute. What I said is that there are those who never speak the truth and never seek the truth in their whole lives. If one were to take the information from the 50 witnesses, then one would be seeking the truth and one would find it. That example you give of 50 witnesses. Well, I have never heard or read any such thing. I have heard that sometimes a very few witnesses might have perceived things differently, but that is not generally the norm. Their different perceptions does not make it not the truth. If one always seeks the truth, they will at minimum be close to it, whereas those that never seek the truth will most definitely never find it. The overeducated seem to always not be able to see the simple facts due to having clear thinking clouded with too many sophisticated trivialities. The overeducated are always the ones that cause the most serious harm, as they think they know everything but cannot see anything. Truth is a living thing, and as such truth is always changing. One has to continuously seek the truth. For the second you stop seeking it, you will be lost. Seeking the truth is a positive action, which will always yield positive results. Not seeking the truth will always yield negative things. Those that seek no truth therefore can only end up doing negative or bad things. I live for truth. Do you? So you stated that by definition, insanity is not the opposite of truth. Truth is a single word. So please place a single word on this line underscore that is the opposite of truth. Only one word allowed. If you are so smart and correct, then you should be able to find that single word. Hint. There's no other single word than the one I indicated that can fill that line. Unless you try to cross over the line of reason, which leads to insanity, unknown commenter say this was exceptionally beautiful piece of writing. We are the people who will expose the lies of the secret societies because we hire deceivers and liars. Therefore, we need to be educated with the truth so we can have the stick of truth and use that to destroy the web of lies around us. Jason Baylor says once again, Daniel, excellent. Thank you for your contributions. Jeff says this is amazingly insightful and real. Thumbs up. Jason Baylor shared a link on your wall. Hello, Daniel. You have some amazing things to add to the group with your brilliant writings. Would you want to be an officer to the group? Awake, aware, and part of the solution. Reply by Starbright O, and I would add, from my honor inner gut. There's a lot of negative stuff here, shocking stuff. Perhaps the antidote would be to start posting things that are lights and beacons of hopes, some, what can I do kind of postings. Just my opinion, being a light worker. This repeated focus on the dark with no spark of light only. Reply by Daniel J. Towsey, a truth soldier. I recommend you read some of my personal writings. The answer is very clear as what to do. Get involved in the truth revolution. Truth is the only answer. That is the next step and the only step. Exposing the evils is the only way to be able to make any change. As always, only the strongest will survive. Survival of the fittest. One cannot be fit without a healthy mind. That can never happen without seeking truth. Please read my article, The Web of Deceit, Reply by Starbright I. Daniel. I did read it, but like I said, I think we need to start putting out some positive stuff by feeding only the negative to the world. Aren't we just reinforcing the negative, the evil, keeping it strong? I read a lot. But there already is too much on this site for me to go through. I've not been around as long as you have, and if I find it that way. What about the guy or gal who joins up next week, next year? Just expressing my thoughts. And this is only my personal opinion about what draws me to a site or a posting. It is when a person gives a quick one or two line overview of what to expect to get should I decide to read the article that they are trying to get me to read. I get hooked, and well, if impressed by the overview, then proceed to read the entire article. Thanks for all your sharing. Reply by Daniel J. Towsey, a truth soldier. Hi, Starbright. First, what I write is not full of negative and evil. I do provide the solution and the positive. Nothing will get better or be positive until we face the truth of how bad things really are. An overview is like judging a book by its cover. I do not like overviews, for it will not be useful to educate or deprogram people. Only the intellectuals will have the sense to keep reading. The rest just have really short attention spans, and there is not much I can do about that. I have written all my articles in simple English so I can reach everyone possible. But there is nothing simple about what I write. The problems and evils we face are absolutely limitless insanity. Truth and exposing the truth about the evils is the only path to making things better. If the future of humanity is not guided by truth, we will all be doomed to the darkness of evil. Truth is absolute and insanity is the absolute opposite. I choose truth. Truth is an action. It does not stand still. One has to continually engage themselves in the pursuit of truth. Truth can only be alive if it is something you choose to seek. Truth cannot and will not exist without your action. Whereas insanity can exist and does exist without action. Insanity is the death of one's soul. I choose to be alive. It's time to get yourself a stick of truth. JustBizarre.com submitted on 2011 T1/29. I read many blogs, but I must say your writing style is top notch. You make other bloggers look like kids. Keep up your original writing style.